In less than 48 hours, the scientific world was shocked by a series of extraordinary geological events that rocked one of the world's most active volcanic regions, the Yellowstone Caldera. Thousands of micro to medium-sized earthquakes, with the largest reaching a magnitude of 5.9, struck the area around New Crater and the Norris Geyser Basin hot springs. Shortly afterward, researchers recorded significant magma movement rising to the surface beneath the caldera. The culmination was a shocking eruption from Steamboat Geyser, the world's tallest active geyser, spraying hot water and steam 35 meters into the air, breaking the record for the highest eruption of the year. These three events occurred almost simultaneously, raising concerns among geologists, park officials, and the thousands of tourists enjoying Yellowstone's new features this summer. Sunday morning, thousands of visitors enjoying the opening of new trails and interactive features in the Old Faithful area felt a strong tremor accompanied by an underground rumbling. The ground was pulsing. We thought it was part of an educational earthquake simulation until everyone started panicking, said Laura Kim, a visitor from Seattle. The tremors are estimated to have originated 3 to 5 kilometers beneath the Yellowstone National Park landscape, right above an active magma system that has long been monitored. Seismographs around the caldera recorded a spike in intensity for approximately 90 seconds, enough to trigger an emergency alarm and close all new tourist trails just hours after their opening. Park officials immediately evacuated several vulnerable zones and restricted access to the Norris area, the Upper Geyser Basin, and around Yellowstone Lake. On Friday morning, August 8, 2025, Yellowstone's seismic monitoring system recorded more than 200-300 earthquakes in 24 hours, the highest daily seismic activity recorded in the region in more than a decade. This series of earthquakes, known to experts as an earthquake swarm, has raised the alert level for scientists and national authorities for a potential major geological event in the Yellowstone Caldera. Most of the earthquakes were centered around New Crater, a previously relatively stable geothermal zone. The earthquakes varied in depth, but most occurred in the 2 to 5 kilometer range, a sign that hot fluids, gases, or even magma chambers were moving toward the surface. This is not normal activity, said Dr. Raymond Elkins, a geophysicist at the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory, YVO. The scale, the speed at which they occurred, and the location of the epicenters are very unusual. We are seeing a significant increase in internal pressure. A few hours later, coinciding with the increase in earthquake activity, ground deformation sensors along the caldera perimeter indicated inflation, uplift, of between 4 and 7 centimeters in less than 2 days. This type of inflation is typically caused by magma pushing from within toward the upper crust. The field observation team also reported rising temperatures in several hot spring pools and the emergence of new fissures around the Norris Geyser Basin. At some points, the levels of gases such as sulfur dioxide and carbon dioxide in the steam have increased dramatically, reinforcing indications that Yellowstone's hydrothermal system is under pressure. The culmination of this series of eruptions occurred Saturday afternoon, when Steamboat Geyser, the world's tallest active geyser, which typically erupts only every few weeks, erupted with incredible force, sending a plume of water, steam, and volcanic gases more than 35 meters high. This eruption was one of the most powerful in recent months, breaking records for hydrothermal pressure and surface temperature observed in the area since the beginning of the year. This eruption is not only a spectacular natural phenomenon, but also a strong signal that Yellowstone's underground system is experiencing significant stress. Scientists from the Yellowstone Volcano Observatory, YVO, called the eruption an indicator of a sudden pressure release, likely the result of the accumulation of superheated steam driven by rising shallow magma in recent days. According to Dr. Eleanor Vance, a volcanologist with the USGS who monitored the site directly, the Steamboat eruption is not an isolated event, but part of an increasingly consistent pattern. An eruption of this magnitude indicates an increase in pressure within the hydrothermal system. This is not a magmatic eruption, but it could be a valve that temporarily relieves pressure at some point, though not necessarily enough to stabilize the entire Yellowstone geothermal system. After the eruption, sensors around Steamboat recorded changes in ground temperature, increased sulfur dioxide emissions, and new cracks in the surface layer. Researchers also observed thermal anomalies in nearby, previously quiet, hot pools. However, after the national park's landscape was hit by three simultaneous incidents, scientists confirmed there were no signs of a major eruption imminent. This is part of the dynamics of an active supervolcanic system. It's scary, yes, but it's still within the normal range, even if it's extreme, said Dr. Heller.